preparing a raw horn. So you see inside there, all that stuff, that is marrow. If you happen to get one with a big chunky marrow in it, you want to heat it up to get all that out. We're still going to use hot water to get this out. So basically, you fill it with hot water. Make sure it's nice and hot. You don't want to boil the horn though, because it can deform the horn. And then, once you get it nice and hot, scrub the crap out of it. Assorted bottle brushes will work. It's good enough to use something too rough too. Like, if you look at this, it's a bit thinner. So you can actually see my fingers in there because it's pretty thin and transparent, which looks cool, but it's not exactly the strongest thing. So you don't want to heat it up too much and you don't want to use anything metal. So after your horns are clean, you want to set them up to cure, essentially, for 8 hours. I like using a box because it's easy to conform the shape of the horn to a piece of cardboard after you stab a hole in it. So simply take your regular little everyday carry knife and make a few holes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, and we'll shove them on in there. Actually, let's do the chody ones right here. Keep in mind that the Guinness is going to be as even as possible. This one's got a little hole in it, so it'll be a little lower. And that's why I do it outside, too. Obviously, I'm here in the garage where we can clean it up if it gets too bad. Because I have had them leak. Someplace you don't mind a bunch of beer spilling is good. And the Guinness seems to mostly just take out the cow taste. Because if you give that a hearty whiff, you'll smell a bit of cow in that horn. And you don't want to taste cow. Well, not that one. Then you take your Guinness. Foams up a little bit, so we'll pour a little bit in each. Woo! See, look, spills already. I forgot to think about foam. Guinness fuels my Irish superpowers. And you'll find, depending on the shape, they fill up pretty quick, so. And just set them in a spot where they can sit for 8 hours undisturbed, away from dogs and small children, and the occasional errant alcoholic. That's pretty much good. One more, top it off. So right now I'm just gonna wait for the foam to go down so I don't have to record that. And then I'll come back out and fill it up with the rest. And then after they're cured, you know, rinse them out real quick. And then a good good test is filling them up with water and then tasting in it. And if it tastes a little bit like the cow, obviously you need to clean it out a little bit more and try curing it again. So. And that's how you freaking prepare drinking horns. So these I got from a website. I'll put a link in the description. They're pretty cheap. I buy them in bulk, like $5 a piece. They sell them as powder horns. I have gotten ones where the tip is gone. So just keep that in mind. And like I said, sometimes they have holes in them. But for the most part, it's pretty good. I even have a big, or got a big 20 ouncer that I left with you know, the Skjolder Kindred back in California. Yeah, I'm planning on getting another 20-ouncer because you can buy individual ones in there too. And I am not affiliated in any way with them. I just simply like to use them. I think they're from India or something like that, but I haven't had any issue. I've ordered from twice now. One of my kin back in California ordered them once, and you know, no issues so far. So yeah. And with the quarantine going on right now, since as I'm filming this, it is 2020. It's a good idea to have everyone have individual horns, and you know, maybe have like a one sacred horn where you bless the mead and pass it around. Which, like, even when there wasn't a pandemic, we've had people get sick during holidays. So, yeah. I'm not a big fan of the dark stuff. I like the other stuff. Skull!